Using a foot switch with a resistant soldering iron is not always that easy to do. Would you like to make it easy by making a simple, inexpensive switch that you can forget about and just pay attention to your work, and one that you can use with other tools? Well, that's what I'm going to talk about now. Hi, I'm Gary, recording this from the very heart of Europe. I produce a kit you can use to make your own resistant soldering iron at less than 25% of what you pay for most plug-and-play irons. All about that and much more on resistant soldering is below and at the end of the video. I also wrote a book on resistant soldering. It's free. You can download it through the link below. This is my DIY foot switch that I use for my resistant soldering iron. I'm going to give you an overview first as to how it works, then I'll move it up onto the table, go close, and show you how it's constructed. But in general, what we have is a switch which is a foot pedal. The foot pedal is very easy to find. I don't have difficulties with those little foot switches that you get that move all over the place. I also, many times, turn this and leave it like this. It's easier to find, actually. I can click it anywhere down here, and the switch will activate. I can totally focus on my work, and I don't have to think about where the switch is. Over here, I have a receptacle. It's a grounded receptacle, so it goes to my household ground, and it will ground my resistant soldering unit and any other thing that I plug in. Everything goes through a junction box. I'll show you that junction box after a bit. Now, one of the things that I like about this is I can use it with my hot air gun. When you use a hot air gun, I'm sure you know, it's a pain in the neck to adjust your temperature. I set everything up once. Then when I want to shrink some tube, it's a matter of stepping on the switch. It turns on. I can shrink when I'm done, and it's off. And then it's off, and I can put it aside. Very simple. So, on, off. I can use this also, I use it also for my rotary tools, my buffing tools, and my MIDI table saw. So, that's the overview. I'll move this to the table now, and we'll get into details. This is a close-up view now of the DIY foot switch. It is made from scrap MDF. I had things laying around. I used them to make this whole unit. The switch itself is nothing more than a couple pieces of scrap MDF. I make the hinge out of cable ties. I had brass hinges there, but the bolts and nuts protruded, scraped the floor. So I put cable ties in, worked perfectly well. On the other end, I have a couple other cable ties to limit the extent to which it opens. I put in here a musician's foot switch. A link to get one of those is down below. And then that goes in to a little electrical box for security cover. It's very easy to use. One change I would recommend you consider was, rather than just MDF, a little flexible, go with a piece of strong ply or thicker wood. It'll make it easier to step on from down here. Now, on this side, I put in a grounded receptacle. It goes back to my household power. So I can ground my resistance soldering unit through this and any other tools that I use. To make sure that this doesn't accidentally get turned on or pressed and start a tool, because I keep my resistance soldering unit hooked up to this all the time, I have a switch. Turns it on and off. So I can have it off. If I press something, presses here, it doesn't start the unit. Everything goes through a terminal board. And that, again, something I had laying around. Very effective, very inexpensive. Oh, on this one, I use some wine bottle corks for legs to hold it up. I had wine cork on the bottom of this originally, but I find it better if you leave it flat on the floor. You may want to put rubber on the bottom of that so it doesn't move around too awful much, but I find this satisfactory, and you'll see how earlier in the video it worked.
That's that for now. Next, be sure to download your free copy of the book of resistance soldering. There's a lot in there that you might find interesting and valuable. And be sure to keep watching, because we have a lot more on resistance soldering at the end of the video. I hope that you visit us again when we post our next video. To be notified when we do, subscribe and click on the bell. While you're at it, a like sure would be appreciated. If you know anyone who might be interested in resistance soldering, go ahead and share the video with them. Once again, thanks for visiting us, and I hope to hear from you. So don't forget to ask questions and comment.